Good afternoon folks and welcome to another video. Today I'm going to have a go at reviewing three different disco consoles that I actually have in my collection and try and explain the features and why specific DJs would have gone for them. And I can't, the only thing I won't be able to do is discuss price, because I don't know how much any of these were when they were new. If anybody knows, then yeah, tell me. But I don't, so I'm not even going to estimate. But I do know which would have been the cheapest and which would have been the most expensive. But we're going to start with the earliest console in my collection. This is the Cytronic SM330 Stereo YE Mark III. Some say possibly the best disco mixer ever made, possible, for a console anyway. It's quite possible. It's certainly better than the Cytronic stuff that's made these days. I know, I had one of their modern consoles and the controls didn't feel anywhere near as nice, they felt cheap. Anyway, enough on that. I'm not going to slag Cytronic off because I like them. Anyway, the second console that we're going to look at is the Cytronic 7, which is a mono unpowered. Oh, this is unpowered, by the way, this Hawaii, that's unpowered. Now the third console we're going to take a look at is the Linear Sound Tornado powered mono console. This has 100 watt amp in it, came supplied with speakers from the manufacturer. That's how you got it. You bought that, you got those. And it was as simple as that, really. This is the cheapest console in my collection, so we'll start with this. But before we start anything, I need to make a brew. I'll just put the video on pause and make a brew. Be back shortly, folks. Right, welcome back folks. Where were we at? We were at the Linear Sound Disco console. Now, I'll go through the features on this and I'll explain why it would be the obvious choice for the budget price, and I don't want to say cash strapped, but the DJ that was just starting out, the beginner DJ. I mean, I would have bought one of these as well in the day, more than likely, given that you know, they were they were cheap, budget priced. As somebody described them, Fallon Linear, the Dansett of the disco world, and yeah, that's quite true. Cheap and nasty and got the job done. Yeah, how about that one then, folks? Right. Well, you have your monitor out, obviously, for your headphones, your microphone and your tape. There is a slave output on this. It's round the back there, round the side. And on the side there, you've got your, excuse my junk, my soldering iron and stuff, but you've got your power switch, speaker in jacks, and your power connector. And you've got that output socket there, so you can use, obviously you could use a bigger amp if you so desired, but this comes with 100 watts on board, built in. It's what's known as powered, and all the controls on this unit are rotary. You've got your monitor, it's all divided so it can be read easily. You've got your monitor, your mic controls, bass and treble and mic volume, your deck faders, deck switches, your tape or your auxiliary, as a lot of people know it as these days. Auto fade level, which I never saw the point of that, but it's there anyway. And deck and tape EQ. Why don't you just say tone controls EQ? Yeah, bass and treble, or treble and bass, and then your master control here. Fitted to this, we have We have Cytronic CL12D turntables. It didn't originally come with these. It came with cheap plastic things, and I mean they were cheaper than these. I mean these are plastic, but they were just disgusting. So I bought these and I put these in. New belts, new needles. Well, there's no stylus in this one. No stylus in this one because I borrowed the stylus to when I was sorting out the 7 over there. And it's still in there. So we'll just listen to one. Just listen to one of these decks. Although they both do work. There we go. They're both on. Both do work. Just give that a stroke. As you can see, no needle in it or stylus in it. Right, let's just give you. Oh, we want the right speed. Speed selector there, 45 and 33. This is difficult. There we go. There we go. Holding the camera and putting that on. Give you a quick, I think we're allowed 30 seconds of copyrighted material on YouTube, I don't know, but that's not too bad. I've got a dirty speed switch there. Yeah. There we go. Got a dirty speed switch there. I must have forgot to spray that when I serviced the decks. Never mind. Either that or I didn't pull the switch fully down. Because with these, if you move them slightly off, there we go. Whoa. They fly around, so I might not have had the switch fully down, but that's that one. Now a lot of DJs that did small to medium sized venues, this would have been a good choice because it came with, as I've already said in the introduction, it came with its own speakers. So you didn't have to worry about that. It had 100 watts on board. Well, it has 100 watts on board. So you don't have to worry about amplification. 100 watts these days is not a lot, but it'll fit, trust me, it'll fill a small pub. Small to medium sized pub, it'll have no trouble. And these were also budget priced units as well. There was I don't know how much they were new. If anybody knows, then comment on it, tell me how much these were new. I'd say, what, I don't know, I'm not even, I think I said in the introduction I wasn't going to hazard a guess on the prices. I'm not going to hazard a guess on the prices because I don't know. So anyway, we'll move away from that and we'll take the record with us, and we're now put a proper centre spindle in. This has got two new stanchions in it, which were put in only a couple of days ago. Right, and right, this is change hands because I'm left handed, but I operate decks with the right hand. Don't ask me why. Let's put that one on there. Put that one on there. There we go. Now, as I've already said, this is the Cytronic Stereo YE Mark III using the SM330 console mixer, the Cytronic mixer, obviously. Now, this would have been the most expensive out of the three units that I have. Reason for that is A, it's stereo, and B, this has more features. It has It has an extra mic socket, so you got two. You got two microphone. You got two microphones on this. Each with the tone controls control both mics, but individual level controls for each mic. That's good enough. I'm not going to plug mics in because my mics don't fit these. My mics are XLR sockets, so I'm not going to muck about plugging mics in. You have your controls here, your auxiliary. You have your auxiliary, you disc 1 and disc 2 and your tape, so you can actually plug 3, you can actually plug 2 auxiliaries lining into this if you wanted, 2 auxiliaries, because you can plug your auxiliary into that 5 pin din there, and you can plug, it was on here somewhere, oh there it is, you've got your tape socket there, so you've got your 5 pin din here. My camera works terrible. And you've got your tape socket in, your output is there, your slave output. You've got two different outputs on this. You've got a high level output, which is 2.5 volts, and which is what I use it on. And you've got your slave there, which is just normal line level output, I would have thought. It's lower anyway. It makes a difference when you switch them. This is fitted with Garrard SP25 Mark 6s, I believe, which that's what the V in Roman numerals means. It didn't originally come with Mark 6s, it originally came with Disco Drive 80s. But I changed them. I bought these new old stock, these turntables. Got them new old stock about 3 or 4 years ago, maybe a bit longer. There's a layer of dust on them, do need a clean, I appreciate that. I understand that, and they need to clean, but these turntables work absolutely beautifully. No wear in them, they've never done a disco, these. They were still sealed and in the box when I got them. And right, well, let's go for a record. And there's a difference, because this sounds absolutely brilliant. So let's turn the amp on. Would help, wouldn't it? Let's give you a quick listen. Let's get that one on the go as well. Now that sounds better than what the linear does. There we go. Let's take them. Right. That's a bit, and now to the point of why a DJ would have gone for this. Well, the first plus I think is it's stereo. Would have been a pretty well off DJ to afford that in its day. You know, he would have had a lot of gigs in his book. Kind of DJ that would have been out every night, more or less, every Friday night and Saturday night at least, to afford this unit. Well, the plus points he would have had was, yeah, the extra connectivity of having the auxiliary and the tape socket, the extra microphone socket, because when you do weddings and stuff, I know I've done them, when you do weddings and stuff, a DJ doesn't like to give his mic up. So having an extra mic, yeah, it's always a plus. Obviously independent controls for each channel. No built-in amplifier to worry about, because consoles were naturally known for destroying their amplifiers. I've been to a few do's myself, a few pub discos and private weddings and stuff where the DJ's overdone it a bit and killed the amp, built-in amp. That's why I've always been a lover of consoles without a built-in amp. I use this amp down here, which I'm not going to explain about because it's not under review. But it's a good amplifier. Right, now onto the onto the last of the three consoles in my collection, and I need to first turn this amp off, turn this console off, because I need to nick the power lead, because I need to plug it into here. Now I know the 7 didn't originally come with an IEC socket. I fitted that when I did the repairs and renovation on it the other week. Right, so we need the console switching on, and I'll just go to the back here, put my hand down there, and turn that speaker on. There we go. Because this is right onto the third console that we've got under review, or we're going to look at least. This is the Titus Cytronic 7 from 1982, which is fitted with BSRs. Plus points of this one. It was mono, so it wasn't as dear as that, as the stereo model we just looked at. It was unpowered, so no built-in amp to worry about. No exploding internal amp, didn't need it. A nice clean design, all the sockets on the front out of the way, no wires sticking up. I mean, this is a bit of a, let's just go back to this one for a second. This one here, the only one of the downsides to it is all the wires. But there again, you can modify these, because all these plugs are duplicated on the back. So you could, if you wanted, cut all in the back and put a plate on and mount all these and take all these to the back if you wanted to do that, but you've got the mains on the top and everything. I just think it's a bit of a daft way of doing it, that putting in, but you know, dobbing big mains plug on the top there, IEC connector going in there. Now this is a nice clean design at the front. There's nothing plugged into the mixer on the top of the mixer, so it's completely, yeah, it's a nice clean design. A lot of Cytronics were like this, in this particular case anyway. Well, they pretty much all were in this particular case design. The case design itself is a nice design, although I don't think it lends itself to being particularly mobile DJ-y, because it came in a cardboard box and you had to transport it in a cardboard box. Admittedly, it was a thick cardboard box, but it was still a cardboard box. So, right. On this one, what have we got? Well, we've got microphone on and off. We've got override. We've got an override. We've got override on that one over there. I forgot to mention that. Which is a manual version of auto fade. You just press it down. You've got tape, you've got your bass and treble and level for your mic. You've got your tape, your two decks, your monitor, which is your select what you want to listen to, and your volume for your headphones. Your treble and your bass and your level, your deck start switches, and your power on off, IEC connector. This didn't originally come with that. I fitted that, as I've already said. It came with a lead sticking coming out the front, which is still better than an IEC connector on the top, but I preferred IEC connector, so I put one on. Now let's get these two on the go, and right, let's just change hands. Now we'll get this one going. Let's turn that bass down a bit. There we go. As you can see, both decks work absolutely nicely. There's no, you know, they're not bad for 30 odd year old, maybe 40 year old BSRs. This would have, like I say, these, turn that down a bit. Like I say, these are not the original decks that were in this. Somebody's put these in, I've just refurbished them, because it would, if I'd have bought this new, it would have never have ended up in this state. Because I look after my stuff. In fact, all my consoles are in the condition they were in when I bought them. Because I don't abuse things. And a lot of these were abused, and I don't understand why, given the DJs at the time would have paid a lot of money for them. You know, don't understand that. Still, never mind. You know, they were a tool, like a screwdriver or a spanner. You know, they were a tool that a DJ took to work with him. Anyway, let's turn that off, as we'll go over the 30 seconds. And now, why would a DJ go for this? Well, in my opinion, a DJ would go for this simply because its size, it's compact, it's small, it's smaller than this, it's smaller than that, it's lighter, it's simple, there's nothing complicated, it's mono, which means he only has to buy one, which means it's cheaper. His amplifier is going to be cheaper because he only needs one amp. In theory, he could only use one speaker as well, although many use two. Well, just about all of them use two. But in theory, you only need one speaker. So, if you're really on a budget, then this is something to go for, isn't it? I mean, you could use one speaker with that over there, but the manufacturers gave you two, so if you've got them, use them. These were particularly favourites in small pubs. Along with the Cytronic Popular and Stereo Popular, because the Mono Popular and the Stereo Popular. It's this is basically the same mixer. The layout looks the same. And like I say, there's no amp to self-destruct. Because, as I've already said, we all know console amps did have an habit of being overdriven. Especially the sound out ones. I did actually get a sound out many years ago, and I stripped it. I bought it for the two Garrard decks that were in it, and the amp had already been destroyed. The amp was knackered, so I didn't even attempt to repair it because the rest of it was scabby. So, you know, the mixer was all scratched and marked and generally looked like it, you know, it had been abused. So anyway, that's another matter. But I can't give a price point on this unit either. I wish I could, actually. You know, we know that that Linear was the cheapest. This was the next one up. And this was the dearest. But, right, which one would I have? Well, there's no contest, is there? You know, if I had the money at the time in 1980 when this was new, if I'd have had the money to afford this, then I would have gone for this or something very similar. Either this or something like a TK Disco sound. I'd have gone for something like that. Mind you, I don't think I would have gone for the TK Disco sound because I know a guy who's got one of them, and I lifted it up once, and the damn things weigh a ton. Mobile, yeah. Mobile unit, definitely. If you're built like Arnold Schwarzenegger. Yeah, definitely. They weigh a ton. But there again, they've got a massive bloody big amp in them and all. NJDs, I've had a couple of them. And they're heavy and all. And the ones I had, well, one of them was powered. It was a powered mono, but the amplifier didn't weigh a lot, there was now to it. But they still were, and the stereo one, it weighed about the same. They were just heavy. But there again, they were made out of thick material. I think they were plywood. No, they weren't plywood, were they? They were cheap. I'm not sure what they were made out of. Probably plywood, but no, actually they were chipboard. but they were constructed to take a knocking. But I think this is the most fragile. Out of the three, this is the most fragile, so I wouldn't go for this because it comes in a cardboard box and you have to transport it around in a cardboard box. So for me, this would have been a no-no for mobile disco use. I wouldn't have bothered, I wouldn't have bought it. Not even if I was desperate, I wouldn't have bought it. This, yes, I would have done if I'd have been able to afford one. And the linear, yeah, I probably would. If I was out every Friday night doing small venues, then I suppose this is the unit to have. If you can't afford the equivalent Cytronic or TK or Cloud or McGregor or whatever else was out, or NJD, you know, I mean, these were the cheapest of the pile. So, you know, and plus you got the speakers with it. So yeah, I probably would have gone for one of these as well, but I would have still changed the decks. I wouldn't have had them horrible plastic decks that these come with. I would have gone for better decks. Definitely would have gone for better decks. I wouldn't have had what they give you. So, you know, these are basically BSR. These are basically BSRs rebadged, because the cutout for the motorboard and the transit screws, everything's in the right place. It was easy to cut out, because I have a BSR template knocking about and a Garrard one, so I can cut them if I need them. Anyway, that's it for now, folks, on my review of retro disco equipment. I think I've tried to explain it the best I can from the point of view that I'm looking at it. I'm sorry I can't give any prices, I don't know any. If anybody does know how much these units were when they were new, then yeah, put it in the comments. You know, if you think I've got any points wrong, then by all means, then tell me, but don't be rude about it, but tell me, and I will be doing a separate review on, in fact I think there's one up there actually, I don't have to do one, I don't think, I'll have to check, but I think there's a review on the modern CD, new Mark CD console I've got. I think there's a review on YouTube of that. I'll have to check it, see whether there is or not. If not, I'll make a new one. I might make a new one anyway, we'll see. But I'll have a look at that and see if it ties in. If it doesn't, then I'll make a new one. Right, thanks for watching, folks, and I hope you enjoy this little trip down memory lane. And three lovely old disco consoles. Shame they don't make them like that anymore, and even that. So yeah, shame they don't make them like they did. Anyway, folks, that's all for now. Thank you very much for watching. I'll get this uploaded for you after I've edited it. Bye for now.